This is a place where people used to live. Those who once existed here, they don't exist anywhere anymore. Or maybe they do. What do we really know about the afterlife anyway? Is there really such a thing as a soul? Does it move on after the shell has returned to the earth? Or do we only live forever in memory? Those who once existed here, were they truly happy? Or was it just ignorance, blissful in their unaware state, being willingly led astray by those not of sound mind or intent? When you're lost, it's so easy to be swept up in the blanket of a stranger's ideology. A beacon for souls astray becomes a farmstead, where strong hands and feet and arms and legs and backs and necks are put to work. Everyone pitches in. It is only through unity that we find enlightenment. And it's a particular kind of unity that leaves little room for self-expression. Did you all find enlightenment when you escaped from this finite realm? Is that the reason your generators run cold and your homes lie empty? Is the farmstead in the sky bigger and brighter and more full of joy than any of us could possibly imagine? Or is this all just a terrible tragedy? This is a place where people still live, only they aren't here right now. A house is just a house until it becomes a home. This is a new place, somewhere ripe with its own history. But even in early days, it's clear that your family have made it their own. You've never lived there, but it's a place you could call home. It's a bit of a mess, to be honest, but that's somewhat comforting. It's the kind of mess that gives you proof of life rather than proof of its absence. Clutter, not dirt. An account of the hurried lives of those you love. But this house feels less familiar with each corner you turn, even as you draw yourself further into the private lives of its residents. Perhaps there are truths here you didn't know, and perhaps some you already did. There is beauty to be found in a story being left specifically for you to discover, a way to reunite yourself with an intimacy you once had. And when your family return, this space bereft will no doubt fill with light and laughter. But it hasn't stopped you coming home to an empty house, one that doesn't quite feel like home. This is a place where people once escaped to. Countless folk came and went through the fiber optics of an entirely digital realm, one where lives could be lived exactly how they wanted, no matter what vice-like grip squeezed them in the real world. Communities formed here, ones that crossed geographical barriers. Lives were changed here. It's a storyteller's paradise, told not just through systems and narratives, but through players' accounts of their time spent here. A way to keep hold of something that wasn't really theirs in the first place. No one comes here anymore now. It's a dead space, left to gather dust in the archives of some online mausoleum. a world where not even ghosts remain to haunt it? Was it a binary state? One moment bustling, full of life, the next a ghost town? Or was there a gradual decline? Was this space left to fall into ruin, or was it deliberately destroyed? Was a decision made that sparked ire, or some new, shinier realm discovered that everyone migrated to? What remains? A fiction. A place where people once existed, but as they left, so too did their stories. All that remains are remnants devoid of context, and images that, absent of their place in a wider narrative, frighten rather than bring comfort. This is a place that doesn't really exist anymore. A haunted house that remains trapped in time, locked into place by the conflict of its own birth. No one ever lived here. A facsimile of a home built to prove a point, to demonstrate the ability to sell an idea. Except the idea was never sold, and now the facsimile has become an unending chain. A paradox, the finite infinite. A corridor repeats, a menagerie of ghouls impress, and we doom ourselves to a choice between oblivion and rebirth. No matter how much of this space changes with each loop, there will always be a limit. And the only decisions we can make are to continue on with the charade that this idea will eventually mean something, or shut it down entirely. Haunted by the specter of what could have been, these walls end up telling a different story altogether. One of a hostile genesis, a creator's will spat on and ground into the earth, and a future that seems bleaker by the second. Spite governed this idea's end, and the erasure of an artist's identity. And so this place now exists in my home. Locked to a console that will one day give out, never to be shared or passed down through the generations. Ideas are supposed to last forever. I'm not so sure this one will.